Despite our best efforts at reducing the amount of food and yard waste that we produce, we will still have those unavoidable banana peels, eggshells, and autumn leaves. But instead of throwing this waste in the trash, compost it. It's a lot easier than you think. Compost is a nutrient-rich, dirt-like substance that helps plants grow. Compost is made when food scraps, known as greens, yard trimmings, known as browns, and water are mixed. More on that later. So why should we compost? It saves the earth. When organic material, like food scraps and yard trimmings, is thrown in the trash instead of being composted, it breaks down in a landfill and releases methane gas, which is harmful to the planet. It saves money. Putting less in your household trash means a lower trash bill. Not to mention, you won't be spending any green on chemical fertilizers. It saves the soil. Compost gives your soil the nutrients it needs, helps retain moisture, which means less watering, and fights off plant diseases and pests. Composting is a piece of cake. Remember the greens and browns we mentioned earlier? Browns include things like dead leaves, branches, and twigs, while greens refer to grass clippings, vegetable and fruit scraps, and coffee grounds. Your compost should be made up of equal parts of brown and green material, a little bit of water, and oxygen to help break down the organic matter. Now that you have a recipe, you just need to decide how you will cook your compost. There are many different ways to store and manage your compost pile, so do what works best for your lifestyle. Whether it's an open bin, a closed bin, a pile, or a tumbler, you are still helping to reduce greenhouse gases, so compost on. Hey, you can even let worms do the work for you with vermicomposting. If you've decided on outdoor composting, find a dry, shady spot near a hose or other water source. Add your organic materials, making sure that you have the same amount of browns and greens. It's best to layer them like lasagna, with fruit and vegetable waste under your brown material. This will help ward off pests and unpleasant smells. Add water as needed. When squeezed, your compost should only release a few drops of water. Turn your pile every 2 to 4 weeks to allow for air circulation. Your compost will be ready for your garden when it's dark and rich in color. This can take 2 months to 2 years, depending on how hot your pile is. Don't have space for an outdoor compost pile? No problem. You can compost in the comfort of your home with or without help from a few wiggly friends. Vermicomposting, or a worm composting bin, relies on red wigglers to do the work. All you need is 2 plastic bins with holes for air and drainage, shredded paper, a little bit of dirt, a little bit of water, food scraps, and of course, worms. Just feed the worms weekly. They consume food scraps quickly and in turn produce compost. Stealth composting is a way to compost discreetly in your home. One large bucket is needed with a smaller bucket to fit inside. Holes are punched in the smaller bucket to let air flow through. Food scraps are then layered with sawdust or shredded paper and broken down to make compost. If you won't use the compost but are still passionate about not throwing food waste in the trash, find a local food scraps drop-off site or opt for a solar digester. Solar digesters tend to have a little more flexibility when it comes to at-home composting. It would even be okay to add meat and dairy scraps or pet waste to a solar digester because you're not reusing this compost. You are letting it break down and seep into the earth. Follow the link in the description below to test your knowledge. Thank you very much! Hungry for more information? Check out our website, www.clintonhealth.org/ESWL. Follow Clinton Health on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Blogger, and YouTube.